Zealand still chasing their first ever series win against Fiji, but all eight losses haven't been that far away. And here they come with their first attack. Good work off the kickoff. Dardis, one of the best in the business. Jack Kelly into contact, and straight away, look at the work from Waisea Nathungu, Olympic gold medalist, straight off the bat for Fiji. There he is again, Nathungu. Tuwa to Ioane Temba. He's absolute lightning with the speed on the far side, but tip for tap. Turnover for Andrew Smith. Young 21-year-old for Ireland gets his first jackal of the tournament.
Yeah, well, Nathungu showing him how it's done on the first penalty, and then it's reversed. Really fascinating match, this one. Of course, Fiji, first match under the Englishman, Ben Gollings. Congratulations to him on the appointment. That was handshakes all around. It's incredible playing career, as we know. All-time leading point scorer, but now he's in the coach's chair in a very famous and difficult at times coaching seat.
They say it's the toughest job in sevens. Head coach of Fiji, so much expectation. It's their national sport, of course. Double Olympic gold medalist taken over from Gareth Baber. He's thrilled to be here. They were so disappointed not to be able to make the Spanish legs, had to withdraw late from that. And there is Jerry Tuwai, the only player in history to win two Olympic gold medals. Into the Ireland half for the first time. Temba, that's a loose ball. A little messy early on from Fiji, and there's an error, and it's a scrum to Ireland.
Well, they're massive athletes. Fast, big, rangy. And just look at how, when in trouble, that's the loose pass that gets knocked out. A little bit scrappy from Fiji there, and the Irish are applauding.
Yeah, they're a tough team, Ireland. Remember, they beat France in that repechage to qualify for the Tokyo Olympics last year. They finished fourth in Sevilla, as you can see with that stat, their best of the season so far. And here's the best try scorer of the season so far, Terry Kennedy. Runs into a few Fijians. Dardis there, helping him out through the hands of Andrew Smith. And here's Harry McNulty. Great to see big Harry back in Ireland Sevens. His first time back in the shirt since the Olympics in Tokyo. Spent a bit of time with the LA Giltinis in California, traversing the world, making a few digital videos. He's now back where he belongs in Ireland Sevens, and they got another penalty here. Jordan Conroy here on the near side, just lurking.
Fiji guilty of not rolling away at the tackle there. Both sides, that was Temba not getting out of the way, and there's Conroy. Temba's going to get a bit of treatment here. Good first tackle, but he just doesn't get out of the way, and that impedes the ball from being produced.
Yeah, Ioane Temba on the floor. Just that lower left ankle. Got a bit of strapping on it already. Hope he's okay. So, yeah, Ireland six overall, four cup quarterfinals, as I said, fourth in Sevilla.
Fiji, because they couldn't attend the Spanish events, their last performance was a ninth in Dubai. I mean, how rare is that for Fijian fans? They've had to sit 126 days and deal with that result. They're hoping for something better in Singapore.
Yeah, missed out on the cup quarterfinals. Rare thing. It's happened to them twice in Dubai, actually. But they look really good in the first leg in Dubai, but just second leg with a new team, new season, just looked a little bit worn and torn from that opening leg. Spoke to Ben Gollings yesterday. He said they've had valuable time against New Zealand and Australia at their home tournament. Also the Maris Sevens. But here come Ireland, looking for their first points in Singapore. Terry Kennedy just looks towards Conroy. That giro is well worth watching. Andrew Smith, another Leinster Academy and the Clontarf Club. Another penalty, really racking up against Fiji early on. Lots of defending to do.
Yeah, that was not a very subtle hand in the ruck by the big man.
Yeah, Elia Thanakaivata, the guilty party on that occasion. Look at that, 3-2. Dardis just happy to slow it down. Ireland, they play very disciplined, structured, branded sevens. They don't do a huge amount of offloading in contact. Good on the set play. as they'll try and prove here. Kennedy to Conroy. Good to be reading out that combination again. Smith. Yeah, makes some extra yards on the floor to Smith. Kennedy sees an opportunity on the far side. Here's McNulty, does well, the big man, to pick up that bouncing ball on the floor up to the Fijian 22. Jack Kelly tries to sneak around the ruck, doesn't get that far. Here's Dardis, back to McNulty. Smith again. Here's Kelly. Here's Conroy. Jordan Conroy, a little in and away, and he's gone. Jordan Conroy.
Oh, he's dancing.
With his 57th career try. He's back.
Well, he was runner-up and Dancing with the Stars. He's not getting second place here. Bogunu just gave him a bit too much space.
I'm trying to get them out.
And this is what he's been up to since he last played on the HSBC World Series. A little bit of dance practice.
There he goes. Yeah, he's learned a few things. You got Dancing with the Stars in Canada? What is it? Strictly Dancing?
Yeah, it's on ice and skates with us.
Okay. Yeah. You don't have the ballroom version. Okay. We expect to see Jordan busting a few more moves for us this weekend, not only with the ball in hand, but also with his celebrations.
But on a serious note, that stat there, those 10 passes, really good play from the Irish. Kept possession, didn't let it get too loose. You mentioned the role of McNulty, just tightening it up, showing patience so his pacemen, Kennedy and Conroy, can get their hands on it.
Got a full pass from Hugo Lennox.
That was your man.
Terry Kennedy, how good has he been this season? DHL impact player. He's had two hat tricks this season, 24 tries in all. He needs two more tries to become only the second Irishman to score 50. Of course, his buddy Jordan Conroy has already done that. He's up to 57.
Sit.
Yeah, great scenes last time out. Not only the men getting that top four finish, just missed a bronze, but the women getting to their final.
2-1. Haven't had much opportunity with the ball in hand so far, Fiji. They've been well contained so far, but that might all change here. Rasaku, good burst from him. They get a decision. That'll help. Jerry Tuai goes quickly. Skips away from Lennox. Through Nathuku, Talatholo, he was brilliant in the opening round of the season. Dubai leg one, but Ireland have turned it over again. And they'll go hunting a second score here. Clock's in the red. Kennedy to Conroy. Good tackle on Jordan Conroy that time. It was Temba who put him to the floor. Lennox, Kelly, Smith. Real workhorse, those two, aren't they? Kelly and Smith together. McNulty out there as well. They're a big, burly forward line for this Ireland Sevens team. There's Kennedy. He's got all the tricks. Conroy's got all the speed. Dardis with the vision. Oh, look at that. Skips away. Inside ball to Lennox. Back to Conroy. Oh, goodness me. Kadmila Fulcher. 100,000 welcomes from Ireland to Singapore. That was brilliant.
Relentless pressure for the men in green. The numbers are in the red. They turned the ball over and they just kept attacking. And you mentioned it, Ru. They know their roles so well. They've got their pace men, but the grinders, they have to do the work. Fantastic response from them as that second half is expiring.
Billy Dardis doesn't miss those two maximums for Ireland, 14-0.
Yeah, great work, playing with their head up, all of them. Just looking for the open men, constantly asking questions of this Fijian defense. And saw they're a little late getting back across to cover that short side. Conroy doesn't even need to use his pace to get in for that one.
The slowest try Jordan Conroy has ever scored in his life takes us to halftime. Ireland lead Fiji, 14-0. And don't forget, they've never beaten Fiji on the HSBC World Rugby Sevens Series. So looking to make a little bit of history here, our Ireland. Fiji, left to right now. Get us back underway, and that's been whacked back behind Jerry too wide. And there was a little knock on from Ireland, so Fiji will set the scrum, and perhaps they can get an opportunity here from the set piece.
50-50 ball. There's the volleyball south tap, and it comes off the hand of McNulty. So this is very dangerous. Fiji, interesting, lining with three players just to the top of your screen, showing everything up. Let's see where they attack.
Good to see Matt McDonald out there in the headgear. He contested that restart. He's playing hooker in this scrum. Just made his debut for Ireland Sevens, but Jerry Tuwai sees some space down the short side, and he's got an assist already. It's Nanduvalo who has scored for Fiji. There you go. That'll help the confidence. It was a difficult first half, but straight out of the gate in the second half, they've got a five-pointer.
Well, we talked about the midfield scrum and the opportunities available. Why not let the greatest player of this generation, Jerry Tuwai, set it up? There's the extras, don't quite go. But just simple, simple stuff. He just shows left and then off he goes. Draws three green jerseys and in full stride, unstoppable, is Nanduvalu.
And what a start to his sevens career. For Vui Viawa, Nanduvalu on debut, has his first try for Fiji Sevens on the World Series, and they got the ball back from the restart as well. Jerry Tuwai flings it across over to the far side. They're looking for another, and they'll get it. It is Josefa Talatholo who will score. It was a slow start from the flying Fijians, but they're back doing what they do best.
Volleyball right now, beautifully timed run by our try scorer. Nanduvalo does it off the kickoff. Gathered by Mathuga, and look at that. Two tries in less than a minute and a half. That is Fiji Sevens. They can get you from anywhere.
Exciting player, Josefa Talatholo, DHL Impact player in Dubai. And you'd think that Ben Gollings will be feeling a lot better now about his team's performance. Just 2 points the difference. Well taken by Harry McNulty, brilliantly lifted by Andrew Smith. Gavin Mullen bursts away. There's the debutant McDonald to Smith. He's got McNulty with him. Harry McNulty will just hit rucks all day long for you. That's gone forward at the breakdown. Really good work there from Kaminielli Rasaku for Fiji.
Yeah, those are the little things. Ben Gollins will be happy with that. Rathaka competing at the breakdown. He's won the turnover. Interesting. Gollins has had a lot of time in Fiji, a couple of tournaments, the Fun Flavor Super Sevens, and then the Fun Flavor Fiji Rugby Mini International, where New Zealand and Australia showed up. So good competition ahead of this. I don't know what's fun about playing domestic Fijian Sevens, but no surprise that the likes of New Zealand All Black Sevens didn't get out of the quarterfinals. The standard of those things is just amazing.
Yeah, it's extraordinary, isn't it? All Black Sevens won the plate final at that tournament. They could field 10 sides here and still compete. Fiji, really good second half for them, just as I say that. That's a loose pass. Tracking back for them as the try scorer, Nanduvalo. He's done really well again. And there's Rasaku, who came up with a good work at the breakdown before. High tackle on Tuwai. That was Roach and Smith involved in that contact. And they try the chip and chase. Do Fiji. Terry Kennedy, though, getting back. Nathuku for Fiji.
There.
Shoves Kennedy out of the way. And there's the offload over the top. But just goes a little bit forward. And Nick Hogan, the eagle-eyed Kiwi in his first tournament, spotted that ball going forward.
The one he didn't spot, I think, was what Terry Kennedy was appealing, pushing the back as they were both chasing that kick. Both sides with a couple of handling errors. But the Irish passing, not uncharacteristic. They do like to keep the possession, keep recycling. Good look there of this big Fijian pack.
Time on.
Well, it's not often you see a Fijian side getting out past in a game of rugby sevens. That's Mark Roach, 29-year-old. Gets us restarted. Mullen to Kennedy. Well, wraps up so fast as Terry Kennedy. Mullen does well there. He has to go back and pick it up, but there's the moisture, the humidity on the ball. He was there in good position, but just spilt it uncontested.
Yeah, pretty fast track here, although there's a few divots coming up there, but very humid in Singapore just before 11 a.m. on a Saturday morning here.
Yeah, Fiji drawn in the same pool as Ireland for the first time since Paris in 2019. Four of their past 5 meters have come in the knockout stages, so they've been used to beating each other in the big games. But yes, if they can hold on to this score, this would be their first ever series win against Fiji. And they make a change. There they are, Ireland in six, looking to go further up the table as McNulty and McDonald look to set this scrum.
This is ominous for the Irish, given what happened last time, midfield scrum. Let's see what they execute this time. Same play, couple of more sets of hands and options. He tries to go over the top, but it comes out of his hand forward.
It was meant for Nathuku. Yeah, you can see what Jerry's trying to do. Gavin Mullen. Important intervention from the red-headed Irish player. Had his hand on the upper arm, a two-way. Just couldn't direct the offload properly. What a player this guy is. Great to have him back on the series. He stands above all of them as being a double Olympic gold medal winner. The only player to ever do it.
The man from Buca, Paco Drove, 2019 World Sevens Player of the Year. He's done it all.
Singapore Sevens winner as well. Here is Gavin Mullen. He's been good off the bench for Ireland. He really has. Here's McNulty at first receiver, the big man. Through the hands to Matt McDonald. And here's another player off the bench, Awanusi. He gets the ball to Conroy. He's on a hat-trick. 14-12, a minute to go. Ireland looking for their first ever win in history against Fiji on the series. Here's Roach, tracks back. He's got Kennedy to his left. Mullen as well, but TK just decides to check back inside. McNulty arrives, off to Mullen. Nathuku gets a little bit of help from Vakarunambili in that contact. Kennedy again to Awanusi. Matt McDonald to Conroy. So dangerous, Jordan Conroy. Awanusi again. Kennedy. Roach. Wrong end of the field for Ireland, but right on the scoreboard for them. They lead by two inside the final 30 seconds, looking to beat Fiji for the first time ever. Terry Kennedy. Kennedy,
oh,
burst clear. Terry Kennedy! Oh, he's left it late. The hands in the air. But TK has a TRY to put this one to bed for Ireland. And they make history. They have beaten Fiji on the series for the first time ever. What a moment for the Ireland Sevens.
First pool game, but that means a lot. There's certain thresholds you get on this series. They played for a medal last time out. This time they've beaten the greatest rugby nation, Sevens rugby, there is. And that is something they can stick in their hat, they can keep, and they can celebrate. Ireland getting it done here in the opening pool match.
Ireland have beaten Fiji for the very first time on the World Series, 21-12.
Terry Kennedy.
Well, as you say, it's just the first game. Jordan's got a dance on, couple of tries for him, important.